Good evening, friends. This side, Rahul Magan here is a Group Chief Executive Officer, Treasury Consulting, and also a Venture Capitalist. As we speak, Treasury Consulting Group is a multinational headquartered group based out India, Singapore, and Hong Kong. We do have our offices in three parts of the globe. More importantly, we are a hedge fund, a proprietary hedge fund. Most important, we own our COMEX proprietary platform, our proprietary commodities desk, our learning platforms, Sheetal Academy, and many more things. If you wish to have any information, you can definitely WhatsApp on my personal number, which is +91 9899242978. Alternatively, you can WhatsApp on our back office, which is +91 9818485155. Nowadays, many companies are in limelight. Example, Happiest Mind, because Happiest Mind is around 1500. Barbecue Nation, a loss-making company, Ola. But I don't talk about these companies today. I talk about one company, Airtel. If somebody asked me to be a jury and say that vote for the most corrupt media in the world, then I would title this to India. Indian media is one of the most corrupt media we have in the world. They can paralyze any analysis. And you know why they are doing? They are doing because they knew that majority of the people who invest in the markets, they don't have any knowledge. Forget the analysis. And these brokerage houses, these research firms, till what extent they are paid, you knew very well. From the last several days, I am doing extensive research on Airtel. I collated data. You know that I am a person of data. Even today, I would like to be present a lot of things, a lot of data about Airtel. But before I start, Indian media is always before Vodafone. They left no stone unturned when it comes to criticize Vodafone. And I always say that it is a fault of the Vodafone who is not retaliating in the media. There is a very good saying that if you not retaliate in the media, then people take you at granted. And this is the same thing which is happening with the Vodafone. Indian media writes anything against the Vodafone and Vodafone just listen it. And result, there is a perception in the Indian media, Indian investors, Indian community, foreign institutional investors that Vodafone is a weak company and can bankrupt at any given point of time. And people tend to believe that Airtel is a strong company and cannot bankrupt at any given point of time. So I thought, let's collect the data and then talk with the data, which Hindi media or any other YouTube channel do not talk. You know, I hardly bother about the views, comments, and the total likes or dislikes of my video because I know that my message is actually passed. 30th August 2021, an article titled Airtel Board Approves 21,000 Crores Right Issue. I hope you read through this article or you might be aware that Airtel Board approving 21,000 crores worth of right issue. Now, what the hell is right issue? That is more important. Right issue means that after the IPO, company planning to raise another funding, but rather than giving outsiders the first opportunity. Remember, I use the word first opportunity. Rather than giving outsiders the first opportunity, the board of the company agreed to give the first-hand shareholders the opportunity. Example, there are 10 shareholders in that company who invested in initial public offer. Out of 10 shareholders, 8 quit. 2 quit, 8 left. Company wants more money. Rather than coming up with FPO, which is follow-on public offer, they go with the right issue. Now, which means that the first, and suppose they issue 100 shares. Now, in a proportion, the company decides the proportion. The 8 shareholders who left will get the first priority. If they say no, we are not interested, then these 100 shares will go in the public. Or say out of 100 shares, the 8 shareholders take 80, balance 20. This balance 20 will go in the public. This is called right issue. Now, Airtel board approves the right issue to the tune of 21,000 crores. I know that media just showed this and forget it. And the hard reality, the stupidity is that the stock price went up rather than coming down. Because we do right issue, we do offer for sale, we do FPO, follow-on public offer. In all three cases, there is an equity dilution. Now, what the hell is equity dilution? Now, equity dilution means that the existing promoters will lose some percentage. Now, I would like to retaliate this with the fact. I went through Reuters and collated the data. As we speak, on 30th, you know, as of 31st March 2021, Bharti in Airtel, Bharti Enterprise Limited holds around 42% stake, 42. Followed by Singapore Telecom. We in Singapore call this Singtel, is around 14%. Followed by Life Insurance Corporation, around 3.43%. Followed by ICICI Prudential, which is around 3%. Followed by SBI Funds, 2.3%. GIC, 1.33%. Capital Research Global Investors, 1.31%. Vanguard, the largest hedge fund of the globe, 1.30%. And, you know, if you go, the list is long. So apparently, as of 31st March 2021, as per Reuters, we shared the screenshot on our media desk and Twitter handle. You can refer them. Promoters is around 42%. Followed by Singtel, LIC, ICICI Pru, SBI Funds, GIC, Capital Research, Vanguard, and so on and so forth. Now, 42. Now, let's talk something serious out of this. So, I got the data. I raised the concept of equity dilution. Now, let me make this point more interesting. Indian newspaper, 31st August 2021, live went. Indian newspaper, 31st August 2021, live went. Page number 4. Note that the Bharti fundraise of 21,000 crores through a right issue will come with a 7% equity dilution. I'm not saying this, newspaper is saying this, but it will also strengthen the company balance sheet and reduce the debt to equity ratio. Perfect. How can a right issue reduce debt to equity ratio? Except Einstein, Edison and Newton. except Einstein, Edison and Newton, no one in the whole universe can explain this. So except Einstein, Edison and universe. I repeat. Note that the Bharti fundraise of 21,000 crores through our right issue will come with a 7% equity dilution. Correct. Now let's go back to Reuters again. Bharti Enterprise as of 31st March 2021 hold around 42% of the stake. I know that I'm making a video in August. So if I'm making a video in August, which means that the number I'm using of 31st March, but unfortunately I have no fresh number. I only trust Reuters. So 42 minus 7, which means around 35%. Which means that after this 21,000 crores worth of fundraising, the value of the total holding of the promoters would reduce to 35%. Is this is a good news? Did media told you about this? Did we thought about this? That is more important. Media told or not, because we know that we are in the world of corrupt media. Do we know this about? That's more important thing. But more interesting things are coming. Wait for that. Guys, you would be surprised to know that in our corrupt media, people always raise a question that even in this newspaper, there is a question being raised that the total gross debt, excluding lease liabilities and including interest accrue but not due as of 30th June for Vodafone is 1.922 trillion, which means 1,92,000 crores. 1,92,000 crores. This is the total debt in the books of Vodafone. Do you know that the total debt in the books of Airtel? It is as a closer of 2021, it is 1,62,800 crores. Which means that Vodafone is 1,92,000 crore. Airtel is 1,62,000 crores. So what is the difference? What is the difference? Why we always target Vodafone? Why not Airtel? Is the difference between 1,92,000 crores in the books of Vodafone India compared to 1,62,000 crores in the books of Airtel? Is that difference is huge? So next time, maybe tomorrow, when you see Bharti Airtel stock price is 640 or 650 and any paid speaker comes on Hindi media and say the target of 750, just think about these numbers. By the way, story is not ended here. In 2017, the debt was 1,07,000 crores. The debt was 1,07,000 crores. By the time 2021 came, which means 2017 till 2021, precisely 4 years. This debt is 1,62,000 crores. It means in the last 4 years, Airtel debt grew by 50%. In the last 4 years, Airtel debt grew by 50%. Then why we always target Vodafone? Why we always target Vodafone? What the hell we target Vodafone? By the way, story is not ending here. Let me be honest. Story actually starting from here. This is that Sunil Bharti Mittal made a statement, and that statement is about every 35 of every 100 that telcos generated, which means that there are only three telcos in India. One is Jio, Airtel and Vodafone, only three. Out of every 100 revenue the telco generated, 35 goes to government in the form of taxes and levies. Then how would the companies become profitable? If I am earning 100 rupees and 35 going in the form of taxes and levies, then how I would be profitable? I would never be profitable. I would never be cash rich whatever I do. Whatever I do. And what would be the end result? See this. In 2019, Airtel did the right issue amounting 25,000 crores. In 2020, they did the QIP, Qualified Institutional Placement plus FCCB, Foreign Currency Convertible Bonds, to the tune of 21,240 crores. In 2021, they issued the perpetual dollar bonds of 9,200 crores. And 2021, the proposed right issue of around 21,000 crores. If you add these four numbers, 25,000 crores, 21,240 crores, 9,200 crores, and around 21,000 crores, you would be surprised to know that the total is around 10.5 billion US dollars. 2021 not done as yet. But in less than 2 years, which is from 2019 to 2021, I repeat, from 2019 to 2021, in less than 2 years, Airtel raised 10.5 billion US dollars. You heard me right. So next time when you see that people target Vodafone, just think about these. The last part of the story. Hold on, let me give you the fresh numbers. The times interest earned ratio as of March 2021 is 1.3 times. It should be more than 2, 3 and all. Of course, debt to equity ratio is 2.76 times, which means that behind every 1 rupee of equity, Airtel hold around 2.76 rupees of debt. And do you know the asset turnover ratio is 0.28 cents? Just 28 cents. I'm not against Vodafone, definitely not. But at the same point of time, before once people target Vodafone, I always believe that Airtel is also not in a good shape. But Hindi media always say that Airtel is much better than Vodafone, because the biggest problem with the Vodafone never retaliates. This is Rahul Bhagan from Treasury Consulting Group. You know my number, 9899242978. Have a great time ahead. Thank you. This is the video which is dedicated to the Treasury Consulting Group. And to be very honest, we are keeping this video now onwards at the end of every YouTube video, and all the courses by Sheetal Academy and Treasury Consulting Group. There are many questions people generally raised about Treasury Consulting, the products, the services, and we reply these questions on WhatsApp, LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube and variety of forums.
But the quantity of questions, the queries are continuously increasing. Henceforth, we decided to make a video. Of course, this is not the only video which we are making. Rather, over the period of the time, we would continue to upgrade this video, to be precise, First of all, Treshi Consulting Group is a multinational headquartered group. We are based out India, Singapore, and Hong Kong. As we speak, company is around 5 years plus old, and more importantly, we are 100% cash rich company. Unlike the so-called unicorns, without quoting the name, and even if I quote the name, it's a fact that they never touch the profit. The company is in profits from inception. Since inception, the company is in profit. So we are a 100% cash rich group, 0% venture capitalist, and 0% debt. More importantly, our legal entities invest our free cash with mutual funds and international banks across the globe. We are a client to almost top 10 mutual funds in India, and that is the reason we do have holistic information about the mutual fund industry in India. That's a separate thing that majority of the information never comes in public domain. Even if a fraction of the information comes in public domain, this fraction of information come for one day and then you know how it happens. So as we speak, we do have 3 legal entities, India, Singapore, and Hong Kong. More importantly, we are a cash rich group and we are having 0%, which means not a single cent invested by any venture capitalist or private equity firm. The company has not taken debt from any bank, financial institution, or hedge fund. So we are a zero debt company. That is something which we need to understand very holistically. The following are the products and services we do have about Treshi Consulting. The more detail is coming at the, with the as the video progress. We have our own proprietary hedge fund. Many people in the world do not understand the meaning of proprietary. The proprietary means no party outside Treasury Consulting can invest in our hedge fund, which means that we trade with our own money. We are not accepting anybody's money. Even if you give us any amount of money, any proposal on the table, it is completely rejectable. So proprietary is a word which is often used in United States and Europe, but unfortunately this is least used in India. The proprietary means people trade their own money. They do not trade somebody's money. Even if tomorrow, after listening this video, you come to us and say that I give you $1 million to trade my money, I will say thank you very much. We are literally not interested. We hold our own proprietary fund, and that fund would continue to be proprietary, which means that the outside participation would continue to be zero forever. We includes our this fund includes the equities desk, the commodities desk. We have our virtual comics platform. More importantly, we have our OTT Academy. OTT stands at over the top, just like we are having Amazon Prime, we are having Netflix, Disney. There are so many, OTT platform we have worldwide. Our OTT platforms is not as big because they started 6 months ago. But thankfully, we are having handful of customers and they are growing. In our OTT platform, we are creating video and uploading at the back end of our platform. People with authorized login ID and password can see these videos. Apart from that, no one else is authorized to see these videos. As the video progress, you will get to know that as we are having around 13 plus, which is 13, 13 plus different series as far as the OTT platform is concerned. As we speak, August 2021, it is 13 plus, and we are continuously adding more series. Our idea is very clear. We will reach to 35 or probably 40 series in another 1.5 years of time. We are having our learning arm, which is Sheetal Academy. The details of the Sheetal Academy is given at the end of the video. We have our own family office desk. Rather, very soon, our hedge fund would be a part of our family office. We have our own pension fund desk in terms of consulting. And there are 62 plus different platforms which are listed on our fixed income platform, which is www.fixedincome.global. So as we speak, we have our proprietary hedge fund, we have our equities desk, we have our commodities desk, we have our virtual comics platform, our OTT Academy, our penny stock desk, Sheetal Academy, family office, pension fund, and variety of such platform. TNFX Academy, which is our OTT platform, over the top platform. This platform is having 13 plus series. Now, few I've mentioned, you know, basic series, moderate series, advanced series, valuation series, treasury series, wealth management platform. Wealth management platform is actually integrated with TRFX Academy and would continue to be integrated because, of course, we would be investing heavily in the wealth management platform. When we speak about wealth management platform, we speak about the learnings. We are not talking about the trading. You know, there is a difference. It's a trading platform. Remember this. We have 13 plus different series, like few are basic series, moderate series, valuation series, advanced series, treasury series, research and analysis series, and we have variety of such series. So please do remember that. As we speak, we have around 180 plus videos live. Every week we shot 10 videos. So every month we are adding around 40 to 50 videos, and it will keep. We keep adding more and more videos as the time would come. The target is very clear that we would be having more than 2000 plus videos probably in another 2 years of time, which means a dedicated private platform for learnings. So what is the wealth management platform? A wealth management platform is designed to cover all asset classes of the globe. The asset classes includes the fixed income, currencies, commodities, credit derivatives, structured derivatives, and many more. So I repeat, a wealth management platform is designed to cover all asset classes of the globe. Wealth management platform is also designed to cover continent-wise topic. Continents are United States, Europe, AXI, Asia excluding India. We have excluded India because the financial markets in India are very, very shallow. Like if you speak MTN, medium term notes, if you speak about any exotic derivatives, nowhere people are taking this. In fact, you know that I worked as a corporate treasurer. Even today, 99% of the treasury function in India are working as a cost center. Hardly 1% are working as a profit center. Hardly 1%, to be honest. So the continent-wise include United States, Asia excluding India, Asia excluding Japan, India and Japan, global financial centers like Singapore, Dubai, Hong Kong, Luxembourg, Switzerland, and respective, and of course, Latin America. We are creating a wealth management platform which would be covering everything. Example, CDS, credit derivatives. India is not a market of credit derivatives. Reserve Bank of India on paper allowing credit derivatives, but neither we have buyer nor we have sellers of credit derivative. So on paper you have credit derivative, but practically you don't have the credit derivative in place. Henceforth, we really need to understand that if we wanted to talk about credit derivative, the only markets are US, Europe, or Singapore. India was not a market, is not a market, and would continue to be because we are doing nothing substantial to create a credit derivative market in India. That's the reason even after a lot of frauds which are happening, banks are just writing off the money from their books. Simply writing off the money from their books. Had it been the credit derivative, banks would be able to get their money back. But once again, if you talk about this issue, people don't understand because they do not, they are not interested to have this. Anyways, a wealth management platform designed to cover all asset classes of the globe. And very soon, this wealth management platform would link with our fixed income platform, which is www.fixedincome.global. And of course, we would be adding crypto as well. That is most important. We are planning around 1,000 plus wealth management videos by December 2022, which would be covering continents like United States, Europe, Japanese market, Asian markets, global financial centers, Latin America, the tax havens like Bermuda, you know, BVI, Caribbean and respective, and structured finance, my favorite. 1,000 plus videos would be covering almost everything as far as the wealth management is concerned. We would be covering a very simplistic and the plain vanilla topic. At the same time, we would be covering the exotic topic also. So basically, our wealth management platform is for the people, those who are having zero knowledge, and it is also for the people, those who are having advanced knowledge. Please understand that. It is not designed for the people, those who only have basic knowledge, or the people who wanted to have exotic knowledge. People with the basic, moderate or advanced, they all can participate. This is our TRFX Academy, a screenshot taken from our fixed income platform. This TRFX Academy is our OTT platform, which is over the top platform. And in this TRFX Academy, we are of course interlinking the wealth management platform also. I promise you, probably in another 1 to 2 years of time, we would be adding a lot of content in our wealth management platform and of course our TRFX Academy. Only people with the login ID and the password can enter into this platform. And of course, on a weekly basis, we are trying to have at least around 10 plus videos so that we would be able to reach to the target as far as the December 2022 is concerned. And we are committed to it, sir, to be honest. Treasury Consulting Group having own learnings platform, which is known as Sheetal Academy. As we speak, Sheetal Academy is covering around 13 plus schools. Few are mentioned here. The World of Options, Option Worlds, School of Nifty and Bank Nifty, School of Investment Banking, School of Venture Capitalist and Private Equity, School of Commodities, School of Accounting, School of Foreign Exchange, School of Treasury and Risk Management, School of Forensics, and more schools are coming. Before I change the slide, the purpose of Sheetal Academy is to create a learning platform which link with Thomson Reuters and Bloomberg. We know that we have many learning academies worldwide, and I challenge all learning academy, how many of them are actually linked with Reuters and Bloomberg. I often share Reuters and Bloomberg screenshots on YouTube, on LinkedIn, on WhatsApp, on Facebook, on Twitter. Hardly I see. In fact, limited people in the world are sharing the Reuters and the Bloomberg platform screenshots, because the question is, it requires a very deep and dense knowledge. Once you are sharing the screenshots, you know, people generally ask questions from you, and you should have a knowledge to reply. That is more important thing. Very soon we have more schools coming. So as we speak, we are having Option World, Nifty, Bank Nifty, School of Investment Banking, School of Venture Capitalist and Private Equity, School of Commodities, School of Accounting, School of Foreign Exchange, School of Treasury and Risk Management, School of Forensics. The other schools are School of Trade Finance, School of Regulatory, School of Treasury Technologies, Functional Training, you know, we have functional trainings, forensic trainings, information technology trainings, regulatory trainings, and technological trainings. As we speak, around 200 plus trainings are listed. More trainings are coming over the period of the time. All these trainings and everything are integrated with our fixed income platform. You visit our fixed income platform and you would be able to get all trainings and all information here. Apart from that, we provided you the WhatsApp number. You just WhatsApp if you have any query, and in most of the cases we reply if we feel that the query is genuine. So the Sheetal Academy is a platform whose job is to provide practical and industry oriented knowledge. Of course, we link with Thomson Reuters, Bloomberg TV, and many international magazines, international books, and so on and so forth to provide you as practical training. You visit our YouTube channel. In fact, the video you just listened, you can compare this video with any other YouTube channel and rest you know. Apart from that, we just launched our TCG Video World. What is that? We have people, those who working day night in their respective jobs. Some are engineers, some are finance people and all. They don't have time to attend the regular one-to-one trainings. I agree that they need video trainings, like the content shot in the video delivered to them, and as and when they get time, they listen to it. We launched our TCG Video World, Treasury Consulting Group Video World. In this video world, we have decided to have 100 plus topics, 5 already done as we speak. As we speak, 5 video trainings are live. Pay and get. The only time need is the time to upload on Telegram groups. Every training at least 1 hour or 2 hours. It is a video training. So it is not a one-to-one training. Videos are recorded. You get the videos, recorded videos. Videos to be upload in the Telegram groups, because Telegram gives you the privilege to upload 2 GB of video. Whenever we feel that the video length is big, we request people to share their Gmail IDs. They can create their fresh Gmail ID and we upload the video in their Gmail ID. Which so that because Telegram as we speak is giving a privilege of only, you know, 10 GB, 2 GB. This TCG Video World is covering advanced trainings, moderate trainings, and basic trainings. So basic trainings, advanced trainings, moderate trainings. Please note my next word carefully. All basic trainings would be 2000, which means you choose any topic of basic, you get at 2000. Moderate and advanced training pricing depend upon content to content. So I repeat, TCG Video World is a platform when you have 100 plus topic, 5 already live, 2 hours video training. It's a video training to be uploaded in the Telegram group. If we need more space, we request for Gmail ID. Advanced trainings, moderate trainings, and basic trainings. Please do remember this. And this is live. This platform is well integrated with our fixed income platform, www.fixedincome.global. So this is well integrated with our fixed income platform. This is a glimpse of our hedge fund desk. Like I made myself very clear upfrontly that no third party in the whole world can enter in this platform, which means that we do not trade somebody's money. We only trade our own money. So no third party can enter in our platform. This is only for ours, but this platform covers equity desk. This platform covers scalping group. This platform covers commodities desk, comics platform, penny stock desk, silver scalping fund, which we just started. And more importantly, the Asian desk, where we're covering Singapore and all, and the digital gold. More product we would be launching in this hedge fund. But I will again repeat. No third party except Treasury Consulting can enter in this fund. This is not for outsiders. This is our prop hedge fund, which is completely designed for the organization by the organization. No third party is allowed. And we are very limited companies in the world, those who are running the profitable hedge fund. Our income and everything is really good, but we do not trade somebody's money. These are our credentials. You know my handheld number 9899242978. These are our WhatsApp numbers. Our platform www.fixedincome.global. Email ID rahul.magan@treasuryconsulting.in or info@treasuryconsulting.in. I assure you, probably in another 1 year of time, we would have more than 100 plus different platforms across the globe. Company would continue to be cash rich. We never allow any venture capitalist to enter in our company because we know the side effects of that. And we continue to add lots of products and services. In case you wish to have any information, these are all the credentials. Thank you guys and have a great time ahead.